In this video, we will take a look at the slide of glandula sublingualis. The slide is stained with hematoxylin-eosin. That means that nuclei of cells are violet and cytoplasm is pink. The sublingual gland is covered by fibrous capsule. You can see here. The fibrous trabeculae arise from this capsule and subdivide the gland to the lobe and smaller lobules. For example, here. In the fibrous trabeculae, you can find interlobular duct, for example, here, or blood vessels, nerve fibers. Nuclei of fibroblasts and collagen fibers. You can see pink collagen fibers in fibrous trabeculae. So the sublingual gland is a compound, makes tubuloacinar gland and contains from the serous and mucous acini. Here you can see closely to the lobe, and here you can see mucous cells. The mucous cells are light or pale, and contains small dark nuclei in the periphery, in the basal compartment of these cells. And their cytoplasm contains a mucous vacuole, and the cytoplasm is very, very light. So this is the mucous cells. Serous cells have a round nuclei, for example, here and here, in the basal compartment of these cells, and their cytoplasm is darker and contains zymogenic granules. So this is the serous cells, which form acini, or very often in the sublingual gland, the serous cells form the demilune or cap. For example, here you can see the serous demilune on the end of tubular part, which form from the mucous cells. And here you can see serous cap, few serous cells, which form the demilune, also called Gianuzzi demilune. So it's very often for the sublingual gland. In the lobules, you can find an intercalated duct, but in the sublingual gland, the intercalated ducts are short or absent. Very often, you can see non-striated interlobular excretory duct, which are more prevalent and which is lined with one layer of cuboidal cells. So this is a non-striated interlobular ducts. Very rarely it's visible striated interlobular duct, which is lined one layer of columnar epithelial cells, which have nuclei in the center, and in the basal compartment contains basal lateral labyrinth. This is a basal membrane folds with mitochondria. So it's very rarely visible striated interlobular duct. Bigger ducts which is lined with two layer of cuboidal cells and surrounded by the connective tissue. Here it's a blood vessel filled by erythrocytes. And here it's a very big main duct with this line, which is lined with pseudostratified columnar epithelium. And in its wall, it's a few smooth muscle cells and collagen fibers.